This is Damon here with PicSnub Software. In this video, I'll be showing you how to do an extraction with a partially transparent dress. Now, this is not as difficult as you may think. There's actually a few different ways to do this. One way is you could lasso around this dress and run a dual mask extraction in Easy Green Screen and adjust settings to make this semi-transparency come through more. However, I think an easier way is to just do that in Photoshop, which I'm going to show you here, or that is do that in Photoshop after Easy Green Screen. So I'm running Easy Green Screen in single mask mode. If I was going to use this image for something, I may run dual mask on the hair, but for this tutorial, it's just about the dress part, so I'm just going to run single mask and get right into Photoshop. Now, this is actually really simple to do because Easy Green Screen uses a non-destructive layer mask. And what I mean by that, I'll just show you here. This is what most programs do. Actually, all green screen programs that I know of, they give you a single layer with transparency with spill correction directly applied to that. And that's very difficult to touch up like that. But what Easy Green Screen does, which is different, is it gives you a non-destructive layer set. So you've got the transparency in a mask not directly applied to the image. And then you've got spill correction layers above that. So those are not directly applied to the image either. And so this makes it really flexible to touch up. And the easiest way to do this dress is to right click on the mask and use the select and mask. And what you'll want to use is the refine edge brush and get a brush that's fairly large and then just brush over the edges of the dress, and you can see that's making it semi-transparent. This refined edge brush is very good about bringing out semi-transparency. However, you need to be careful because, for example, if you go over skin, it also can make that look semi-transparent, as you can see there. And so just be careful where you're applying this brush and only use it on the areas that you want to be partially see-through. So I'm going to undo that on the skin because, of course, we don't want that partially see-through. And then just brush over the areas that you know should be partially see-through. Somewhere in there looks pretty good. Now, you do have to be careful because let me see if I can find an area that... Yeah, so like these sequins or whatever you call these sparkly things, you see when I brushed over those, it made those partially see-through, and we don't want that, so I'll control Z there. But anyway, if you get it somewhere where you're just seeing some of the background show through, it's going to look pretty natural in the final extraction. Now, inside of this selected mask here, you've actually got something called decontaminate colors. Now, this is meant to correct for spill correction, and it's hit and miss. Sometimes this works okay, and often it does not work very good. So I'm going to demonstrate how to do the spill correction manually, because usually this is not going to work that great. Now, I will point out too that you are not seeing any of Easy Green Screen's spill correction in here, because that's on a different layer, and when you're in selected mask, you're only seeing that one layer. Once you apply it, Easy Green Screen spill correction will be applied to the image. Now, since I had selected this decontaminate colors, it switched this to an output a new layer. I don't want that. You want to output just to the layer mask. Anyway, I'm just going to hit OK here. And so now you see we have this dress that we can partially see the background through, which is exactly what we want. However, the color is still off, and we could have maybe adjusted some spill correction inside of Easy Green Screen to help out. But in all honesty, something like this is works best to manually just paint that color back in. Now, there is a layer in Easy Green Screen called Manual Spill Correction that is set to 50% opacity by default in Color Blend Mode. So what Color Blend Mode does is it will allow us to fix the color but maintain detail, in luminosity detail in particular, because it doesn't change the brightness or darkness of areas, it just fixes color. And this is clipped to the foreground layer by this little L-shaped arrow. that means it's only affecting this foreground layer. So if you have a background image, anything we do here is not going to apply to that, which basically means you can paint right over the edges and you don't have to be real careful to follow the edges when you're painting. So what I like to do on this is set this to 100% opacity. And then in the brush settings, use a fairly low hardness around, you know, 35 or so. And the opacity, I use around 30% opacity. By default, this will be 100% on your brush. But for this technique, I like around 30%. And it depends. I might use higher for some images. But for this image, there's different shades of pink. Like we got more of a white-ish pink here and then a more of a dark pink down here. And so I like to do multiple passes with this. So with the brush here, if you hold the, you can either set the brush color by clicking in the swatch and setting the color, or if you hold the Alt key down on Windows or the Option key on Mac, it'll let you sample a color in the image. And then you see it sets the brush to that. So you just set it to a color that's adjacent to where you want. And as you go around the image, you can select a different color. And then just brush over that. And if you want it stronger, brush over it a second time, because remember, we're only painting in 30% opacity. Now, if you want to go over it twice, you have to let go of the mouse button and re-click, because if you click and just keep dragging back and forth, it's not going to reapply that brush. So now I'm just clicking several times and going over this, just trying to blend it the best I can. It often helps too to look at this on an actual background color and try to use a color that represents the color you're going to put it against on the final extraction. So if you were doing, you know, something in a dark setting, you'd use that. If you're going to put it against white, you'd use white. I'm just going to look at it against black because I think that actually looks pretty good against there. So I'm going to just finish off and continue. Oh, I got to be on the layer again. And then you got to be careful too. If you paint over areas of the skin like I just did, you may not see that. But if you happen to do that, then just grab your eraser tool and erase that area, because you're in this layer here, so you're not actually erasing any of the foreground. That's about it. Actually, pretty quick and simple. I spent a lot more time talking than working in this video, but as you can see, that doesn't look too bad, and it's not too difficult to do. In any case, thanks for watching this video, and if you're interested at all in Easy Green Screen, please be sure to visit our website. That is easygreenscreen.com.